Hi, I'm Dr. James Machino. Is there a link between sugar and breast cancer? Well, there's evidence to suggest very strongly that there's an increased risk of breast cancer when your blood sugar level is too high. It's also true for some other cancers. And people who have diabetes, where there's blood sugar imbalances, also seem to have a higher risk for cancer. So how does your blood sugar go up? Because you want that not to happen. When you eat too many refined sugary foods, of course, your blood sugar is going to rise. Not being active enough, not enough endurance exercise, tends to raise blood sugar. Having too much abdominal fat, too much fat in the abdominal area, produces what's called insulin resistance. It's harder for your body to clear the blood sugar from your system. Blood sugar tends to be higher. When you eat too many starchy foods, over and above, you know, what your body can really handle, your blood sugar will tend to rise. And the problem with blood sugar is that it raises, if it goes up, insulin levels go up. And the insulin then tells the cells to divide at a rate that's too fast. When breast cells divide at a rate that's too fast, they make more genetic mistakes. They develop more cancerous mutations, and cancer is more likely to occur. And the truth is that cancer cells, once they're formed, feed on blood sugar exclusively. Cancer cells, almost exclusively, can only use blood sugar as a source of energy. So by having high blood sugar, you increase the chance you're going to develop breast cancer. And if breast cancer cells form, they're going to have lots of sugar available for them to spread and progress throughout your entire body. So the prognosis is going to be worse. People who are in the safest range have a blood sugar level below 90 milligrams per deciliter, also known as 5 millimoles per liter. Those people have the best longevity, a lower risk of not only diabetes, but also cancer. Now, I'm telling you this because many doctors don't get excited about blood sugar being high until you're at 126 milligrams per deciliter, or 6.9 millimoles per liter. By then, you already have diabetes. But you need to have your blood sugar way lower than that from the standpoint of reducing risk of cancer. So at your next annual physical examination, get your fasting blood sugar done and look at the number yourself. Make sure that it's under 90 milligrams per deciliter or 5 millimoles per liter. How are you going to do that? You're going to do endurance exercise. You're going to watch the refined sugary foods. You're not going to overconsume carbohydrates of any kind beyond the point of just satisfying your appetite. Stay at your ideal body weight. Have a waist circumference, if you're a woman, below 33 inches, for a man below 36 inches. And when you choose starchy or carbs to eat, choose the beans and the peas because they have a lot of soluble fiber. It slows the absorption of carbohydrates into the bloodstream, so there's not such a big spike. So you're having beans and peas instead of potatoes, rice, and pasta as much as possible. Now, blood sugar is not the only risk factor for breast cancer. So to see the other important strategies to reduce your risk of breast cancer from a lifestyle standpoint, I want you to download my 10-step breast cancer prevention program right now and read it through very carefully. Now at machinohealth.com, you'll see my published research papers, you'll see different videos that I've created, other resources, live footage from my seminars that I've shot, other downloads that are available for free, all of which I know will help you live a long, healthy, highly functional life, something that you owe yourself and I can help facilitate. My review articles and my teaching materials that are available there include all the scientific references, so you'll know that it's from good evidence-based sources, so you're getting solid scientific information on each health topic that I cover. So be sure to use machinohealth.com as an ongoing, reliable source of health and wellness information for both you and your family members. And thanks so much for watching.